Hello and welcome to MAD, Make It Easy Special. I'm sure you all are aware that photography is also one of my hobbies. And not just that, but playing with photographs, playing with light and pictures and experimenting with all of these is what I really love doing. And sometimes these experiments give us some really interesting results. In today's very special series, we shall be making spooky pictures where we not only change the subject, but also play around with the background. We'll have some fun with the x-rays and learn about animation through a flipbook. And finally, in our big picture, we'll use some small pictures to create a really big star. All this on MAD, Make It Easy Special. Photography is in itself a pretty cool art form, but on MAD we always try to do new and cool things with any art form or technique. Do you remember we had taken some of our friends' pictures and made them really scary? But there we had played around with the character in the main subject of the photograph. And today we shall focus on the background of this photograph and find out how we can make it really spooky. But before we do that, have a look at this.
Rob, hey, why are you staring at our band pictures so intently?
I'm going to make your band pictures so scary that even they will be scared by them. First of all, take a photograph. The face should be seen clearly and the background should be plain so that whatever changes you make will be quite easy to do, all right? Let's start. First of all, we start with the eyebrows. Make the eyes really scary. And so we paint them green. The ears don't look spooky at all. What do you think?
True.
Let's try something with the ears. Isn't it looking scary? What else can we do now? Let's put in some Dracula kind of teeth here. Let's add some more exciting details as well. Fun, isn't it? And now we give him a long, scary looking tongue.
Tongue?
Did you see? With a little bit of imagination, you can make any picture look really scary. I'll show you some more that I've already worked on.
Hey guys!
Did you see how with such a simple technique we turned our friends' normal pictures into scary ones? But like I mentioned earlier, in that case, we took the main subject of a photograph, that is the main character, and played around with it. Now what we shall be doing with our new technique is, we shall be focusing on the background and playing around with it to see how we can make it look more spooky. As you can see, I've got two or three photographs here with me, but in all these photographs, there is quite a bit of space in the background. For instance, she is looking up at the sky, and in this one, there's a lot of empty space, and here too is an area we can play around with. Now we shall add some things into the background and find out how the meaning of our photograph or the look of our photograph can become scary. Let's take this photograph. It is a street scene with a bunch of people running towards the camera. Everyone is whistling, everyone is wearing a band on their heads, so maybe it's a picture of a marathon. But now we have to change the meaning of this photograph. I've got quite a bit of empty area around here. So I'm going to put in a huge scary monster. So I've drawn a basic outline of the scary monster and where its head is going to be. Now what we shall do is draw its long tentacles. As you can see, there's not much space here for me to draw in the tentacles. So what we will do is play around with these structures. So one big tentacle will emerge from the back of this and wrap itself around this pole. What you must keep in mind is when you're playing around with these details, you must not make changes in the structures. We draw some more tentacles around some other spots too. Okay, so I've drawn a very basic outline, which is not very dark because we have still got to paint over it. So I'm going to use acrylic colors to paint it with. When you are painting, what you have to remember is that you should not disturb your existing structures and their shapes. But as you can see, the tentacles that I'm drawing, which are wrapped around this guy, what I have done is left the space between his arm empty and painted carefully around it. If the monster's tentacles is going around the back, it will show in the gap between his arm and his body. So you have to paint really carefully when you are doing this. These little details are very important, and now that part that is coming in front, we shall overlap nicely like this. Now let's complete the other tentacles as well. And then I'll show you how we can bring out some highlights as well as depth. Okay, so you can see that by adding a darker shade, I have tried to give it some depth. Now we'll use a lighter shade and give it some highlights. Okay, so now our photograph is complete. As you can see, I have painted a monster in it that is emerging from behind the buildings. Its tentacles are coming in from all four sides and trying to catch the people who are running in the photograph. So you see, we took a simple photograph and added just one thing in. And depending on how we placed it in the photograph, it has made the picture look really scary. I'm sure after watching this technique, you're dying to raid your family albums. So you go on and look for those albums and photographs, and we shall take a short break. But don't go too far, because after the break, we shall be making some colorful x-rays, we shall check out a simple technique in animation, and in the big picture, we'll see the biggest superstar. Welcome back to Mad Make It Easy Special. I've always been fascinated by superheroes, especially the ones with X-ray vision. How cool would it be if you could see someone's skeleton or the inside of his skull? Since I do not possess X-ray vision, I have developed an interesting technique with which we can make fun X-rays. But yes, X-rays are always in black and white, like we have seen earlier. But since we at Mad are always trying new and cool stuff, today I shall be making these black and white X-rays colorful. Would you like to know how? But first, watch this. Today we are going to be making some fun x-rays with x-ray vision. Okay, let's go for it. I made a sketch of my friend. You can see he looks a bit worried. Do you know why he's worried?
No.
When we use our x-ray vision to see what's going wrong on inside of him, then we'll know why. Have you ever held up an x-ray and seen the image of a skeleton in it? So to make a skeleton, first of all, we have to create a cavity out here, measuring it out nicely. Now we cut out the shape. Here we have got our cavity. Next, we take a thin white sheet of paper. Remember to make sure that the white sheet you use here should be a little thin, so that when the light passes through it, you should be able to see through it. Whatever is the t-shirt portion, that is from his shoulders to his hands, we have to cover that portion with this white paper. Now we cut it out neatly. The white paper is now neatly cut. Next, we give our character some color. To give him some depth, we shade it like this. We'll paint the t-shirt as well. Then we give our sketch an outline, for which I am using a marker. We use the marker to draw in his hair as well. Okay, so our character is ready. I'm going to be taking an x-ray of his chest. Huh? What do we have in the chest? Our ribcage. Okay, so I've drawn out the ribcage on my paper here. Now we cut out the shape, for which I'm using a round-tipped safety scissors. I've got a sheet of tracing paper here with me on which I stick my ribcage like this. On the inside, we apply some glue only to the edges and keep the upper edges free. So after sticking it together, we get a kind of envelope. We take our ribcage and place it inside the cavity that we had made and stick it on. Whatever portions are sticking out at the sides, we cut them off. Okay, so our character is now complete. So now, we bring on a light box and I'll show you his x-ray. Are you guys ready?
Yes.
Okay, so there's our light box. And why is our dear character feeling sad? We shall know in a minute. We place it here. Lights on. There we see his x-ray. But what's that in his stomach?
He has got a spoon and fork in his stomach.
Spoon and fork,
and there is also a fish inside.
And a fish as well. Seems like he was enjoying the fish so much he swallowed the spoon and fork as well. No wonder he's looking sad. Isn't it a cool x-ray?
Yes.
Any idea where that spoon and fork came from?
I think so.
When you guys were looking the other way, I quickly put the spoon, fork and fish into the envelope as well. Check this out. As you can see, I had put into his stomach a fork, spoon and a fish.
Yes.
And in the same way, you two can put whatever you like into it and make some fun x-rays. Okay, so this was a technique to make some fun x-rays. It's pretty simple and interesting. But yes, it's black and white. Which is why now it's time to add some color. And to do that, we shall use some colored gel paper. You might notice the paper is quite thick. As soon as you place them on the light box, they tend to glow and look quite colorful. And when you overlap them like this, you will see that color gets mixed. For instance, when I overlap the pink with the blue here, I get a kind of purple shade. When these two overlap here, I get an orangey shade and here a bright green. So in this way, you can try a whole bunch of different shades to make different kind of things. The x-ray that we had here, everything inside, it was in black and white. But if we have the gel paper underneath, take a look, it turns to color. And if you use this colored gel paper to make some interesting objects, cut them out and place them in here, then it looks even better. I've got another picture. Here, I've also cut out the shape of his skull and placed it underneath so that you see the skull within the form of his head. Let's place some stuff inside it and see what it looks like. We'll try a simple shape. We place it inside our x-ray. But to see it even more clearly and enjoy it better, we shall dim the lights. Lights dim. And so we get some more color in our x-ray. We see the image of a fish swimming around in his skull. Let's now try another shape. We've got a tiny little brain. And you can add as many interesting shapes as you like. Do you see? He's got no brains, but he's got a whole lot of gears which keep him in working condition. And that's how you can add color to your x-rays. Lights, please. So, did you get that? By using colored gel paper in your black and white x-rays, you give it a bit of color. Wasn't that cool and colorful? Now think about it, what if we could show movement in these colorful images? I'm talking about animation, for which we had learned a simple technique in two-page animation. And using this same technique, we shall see how we can create simple and interesting stories. We shall make a flipbook. So let's get moving and check out two-page animation. If you observe two poses of the same drawing, one after the other, they get animated, meaning they appear to be moving. How? I'll show you. You take a sheet of paper and you fold it. Then you take a ruler and slit it through, but only halfway. The upper sheet you roll over with a pencil like this. And then you hold it in place. Now with a sketch pen, we make a little drawing over here. I've drawn a picture of a bird. Now we unroll the upper sheet like this and we trace the drawing we have on the lower page onto this page. Now we change the drawing on the upper page ever so slightly as compared to the lower one. For instance, here the bird's wings are up in the air, so here we shall have them facing downwards. Alright, now once again we roll the top sheet over. Then we unroll it. Then we roll, unroll, roll, unroll. Do you see?
Hey, it looks like it's flying.
Yes!
And so your animation figure is ready. With a little practice, you can make even more difficult characters. Mm. And you could paint them as well. I've got some more I can show you. Here we are. How about this turtle? So, we have learned simply two-page animation. Now, if we add some more pages, we can create a whole story. Oh, let me show you. I've got here with me a little notepad. You can use one of these if you like. In the pad that I've got with me, the pages are stuck together at one end. So, you can move it about easily like this. If you don't have one like this, then you can get yourself any kind of a little book. But when you use a notepad, what you have to remember is that the paper should not be too thick, because you should be able to see through the page to the image you have drawn below. Now when we begin from the last page. So that when we draw a picture, we use it as a reference to draw on the next page. Then using that as a reference, we draw on to the next page and so on to create an entire story. In two-page animation, we had used only two pages, which is why we had shown a huge difference in our character on the two pages. But because we are now playing around with a whole book, the changes will have to be a lot more gradual so that the movement is smooth and free-flowing. Now, this wave pattern, I'm drawing on every background. So as you can see, we have used a very simple technique to draw this wave pattern in our book. And once you have drawn the entire background, you can easily add in the characters. To add in the characters, this is what we shall have to do. To draw on the next page, I should be able to see the drawing through the page. We shall bring it up ahead just a little. Depending on how gradual your changes are, your animation will be as smooth and slow. You can keep checking whether your action is okay or not. You will notice that this wave is moving downwards over here. And in our last drawing, our ship was moving straight. Now, according to the movement of the wave, we shall draw it moving downwards. Okay, so you can see that our ship entered from the left of the book and slowly moved along to leave the book from the right. But you have to keep in mind the pattern of the waves, because you have to place the ship according to that. The ship has begun to leave the book already. And after this, the ship has gone out. So come on, let's see how the ship has moved on the waves. Okay, so our ship has started sailing along nicely. When you draw your background on the pages, and when you add different things on the various layers like ship, fish, birds, or whatever else you like, your flipbook story will be ready. For instance, I've got a flipbook ready with me here, so let's see what's happening in the story. As you can see here, a ship is sailing on the waves, there is a fish in the water, a bottle falls into the water, a jellyfish crawls out of a treasure chest and turns into the sun. So using this technique, you can decide your very own stories and create them. Did you see how simple it was to make your very own pocket film? So go on and think of some new ideas for your film while we take a short break. But make sure you come back soon, because after the break we'll be meeting a superstar. My favorite big pictures are the ones in which my subject is also really, really big. And for this particular big picture, I have chosen Superstar Bigby. So let's take a look and see how we can use tiny little pictures to create a big picture. Bigby. That's not big enough.
Black,
Bandwidth.